Hi everybody, welcome back. Tim Schneider with Aegis Learning and our ongoing series about personal power. And as a reminder, personal power is not about, you know, crushing other people, or it's certainly not about, you know, exercising undue authority. It really is about our ability to influence outcomes. Now, today is about goal orientation and purpose. And again, like last time, these are going to be very closely linked. So part of our power is the ability to establish some key goals and objectives, whether that's monthly, quarterly, annually, whatever that is, and then provide focus in moving towards those. You'll notice that people that are very goal and objective oriented have a high degree of personal power because they won't let the obstacles come in their way, or if obstacles do happen, they get around them and get over them relatively quickly. So one of the key things I'm going to encourage you to do, and the time of year is perfect, set some goals for next year. Set a few personal goals, set a few professional goals, and really use those to lock in and drive a big chunk of your personal power. The other side of that is about purpose. And we've talked about purpose on here before. Purpose is kind of a big, broad, nebulous, kind of fuzzy thing. But purpose is really about, at its core, why you are here on Earth. Why were you placed here? What is your, you know, what is your long-term being for? And I can tell you, it's not for going through the motions of clocking in, clocking out, and, you know, collecting a paycheck every 2 weeks. That's not your purpose. To find your purpose, you need to take a look at things that you're good at, things that you enjoy doing, and you got to make sure that those two are together too. Because, you know, I'm good at cleaning the kitchen, but I can tell you, I hate it. I hate every moment of it, but I'm really spectacularly good at it, but that is not part of my purpose. So what you're good at, what you really enjoy, what the rest of the world values. You know, what somebody can look at and say, you know what, you're adding value to our home, to our community, to our world, whatever that is. You got to find that piece too. And then somewhere in purpose too, you know, beyond just I enjoy doing it, it has to light a fire inside of you. You know, it just has to spark a flame of this is what I want to do with my life. This is my direction. This is what I've been called and purposed and built to do. And then the other side of purpose is you got to have a little skill at it. I tell this story probably far too often, but I've seen folks that really enjoy singing, and man, they have no business being in the choir whatsoever. So again, what we have to find is some goal and objective orientation. Establish some, you know, a handful of personal and professional goals for the coming year. And then we also have to kind of discover what our purpose is. And that's going to take a little longer and be a little bit more reflective. But once you're able to lock onto those, that is a good sized chunk of your personal power. Have a great week, everybody, and I look forward to being with you next time.